Why do you think that Galaxy Quest is such a beloved fan favorite?
I think that Galaxy Quest is so beloved by so many people because it's so sincere. And it obviously is a bit of a parody and of this kind of world, but it's so loving and so sweet. And I think also the aliens are just these... It's just these people are... They feel like they're past their prime, or, you know, they can no longer be heroes. And these people come and see them as not actors, but heroes. And so they get to actually be heroes. And I think it's a sweet, beautiful story. For me, it was my first movie from beginning to end that I got to be in. I remember getting a page. It was so long ago. I got a page about the audition at the last minute and went and auditioned, and they were having trouble casting my part. And then I ended up starting work like the next day or something. And to be in the cast with all of those people, Sigourney Weaver, Tim Allen, Tony Shalhoub, and especially Alan Rickman, who was such a kind, generous, and extremely talented actor. And he just always made time for everybody, and lunchtime would come around, and a lot of the bigger stars would go off to their trailers, and he would come and we'd sit with the Thermians every day at lunch, and just was a kind, generous, lovely human. I ran into the director a few years after the movie came out, and he told me that, you know, there was talk of making a sequel, but that they felt like it was such a perfect, a movie that they were worried about, I don't know, tarnishing it or something like that. But this Amazon, I think, has developed a series, and I think when Alan Rickman was alive, it was potentially they were trying to get the whole cast back. But I don't know what the plans are now. I think it's still in development, though, so fingers crossed.
Dodgeball is another iconic piece of cinema. Can you talk about your fun being involved in that and transforming you from the beautiful woman we see to...
Yes, it was hard to transform such a gorgeous face as this. No, but I read the script and just thought it was really, really, really funny. And I had just worked on 51st Dates, and there was a woman who had her hair in braids on the top. I can't remember her name, the actress. She was so funny working with Adam Sandler. She wore big red lipstick, and I thought, oh, that's, she'll be similar because she's supposed to be... really have an attractive body, and then her face was supposed to be really disgusting. So I was like, well, I'll have to... I drew eyebrows on for the audition and put a big mole on and some lips, and then, you know, put my braids at the top of my head and went down there and just hoped I wasn't going to run it, like have to park under a building and valet and go up the escalator. I didn't have to do that, thank God. I just walked in the room and ended up getting the part, and then it was just so much fun. Although the thing is, I don't really throw very well, so... first day of rehearsal, you know, it was all these guys and me and Christine Taylor, and everyone was just like throwing these dodgeballs against the wall, and I was like, oh my god, and then I started throwing really, and then like immediately like pulled, like threw my neck out, and I was like, oh my god. But it ended up being just an absolute blast. It was weird to be so you know, have to be transformed like that, and every day there was a new group of extras, so it was a little hard on my ego, but it was also really freeing to be just, you could do whatever you wanted and be a little bit ugly.
Can you talk about for you what the magic of Roald Dahl is and what it was like working with Johnny Depp in one of his more eccentric performances?
Yeah, it was hard to tell if he was doing Michael Jackson, Johnny Depp, and Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, or Carol Channing. Maybe it was a little, if they had a baby, that would be Johnny Depp in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. And it was just to be a part of such an iconic story. Obviously, that with Gene Wilder having played the part before in that film, and then to be a part of this—I don't know if you'd call it a remake, but another version of the film—was crazy, dream come true kind of thing for me. And to be in Pinewood Studios also, and we were on the Chocolate River set was on the 007 soundstage, and we had 16 sound stages, and I think Richard Zanuck, who was the producer at the time, has since sadly passed away. He said, this is the last time people are going to make a movie like this and have it not all be green screen. Like, there was a room where there was squirrels trained from birth. Just, you know, it was to take the tour of that production was incredible. It was just to be a part of that was huge. And Johnny Depp, obviously. Tim Burton being a brilliant filmmaker and a really kind human being. And him, he just was like, Mrs. Beauregard and Violet are very, very ambitious, so you should be as close to Johnny Depp at all times as possible. And I was like, okay. So I have a few things coming up in the movie Jumanji. I have a small part in that. I have a bunch of other little independent movies in the works, but I also am coming up I'll be working on TV show Mom on CBS. I'll be doing 4 episodes of that, coming back, playing Natasha, a character I started last year. And then I go to Toronto in a couple of months to start production on a TV series called Impulse for YouTube, which is directed by Doug Liman, and it's based on a series of books called Jumper about it's teleporting, and apparently the pilot is quite good, so I'm really excited for that.
Doug's done the Jumper film before. Have you got a sense of how close this world is going to be, or what's going to be?
I know it's different. My daughter, it centers around my daughter, was a young actress named Maddie Hassens, who's gorgeous, and I'm really angry about my husband disappearing all the time. I don't know why, and apparently it's because he's a jumper, and so she's got that gene, I guess, although I hear it's contagious. I don't really know what's going to happen, but working with Doug Liman was really interesting. He's a very, very, very talented man, so I haven't seen the pilot yet, but I hear it's really, really good, so I'm excited to work on something that everyone is so excited about. Like, YouTube was like, we want to put more money into it because they're so excited.